A major turning point this morning in our nation's relationship with France. Anthony Albanese given a warm welcome by President Emmanuel Macron, who appeared to put the controversial submarine deal behind him.
Where we speak about the future, not the past. He's not responsible of what happened.
Let's go to Paris now, where Nine Europe correspondent Brett McLeod is standing by. Good morning, Brett. Does this mean we're all friends again?
We're certainly on a much smoother path and calmer waters than happened when Scott Morrison cancelled a submarine deal back in September last year. You remember, Emmanuel Macron said when he was asked, did Scott Morrison lie to him? He said, I don't think, I know. It was a low point in French-Australia relations. But Anthony Albanese and his partner Jody Hayden got a very warm reception, a publicly warm reception when they arrived at the Elysee Palace here in Paris, the presidential palace. And it was a sign of things to come. Both leaders then made a joint statement. Clearly the words have been carefully chosen, where they talked about the mutual respect that Australia and France have for each other. Emmanuel Macron actually talked about the war history and how thousands of Australian soldiers sacrificed themselves to help protect France. That will not be forgotten. And when it came to the submarine deal, he didn't really want to go there. In talking about the past, Anthony Albanese's got the great benefit of not being Scott Morrison. Mr. Albanese returned in kind when he talked about the need to rebuild trust with France.
Australia's relationship with France matters. Trust, respect and honesty matters. This is how I will approach my relations.
The two leaders, after their working lunch, did release a joint statement, and interestingly, defence was a big part of that. They both agreed to work together to have more defence industry cooperation between the two countries, and crucially, France will not get in the way of Australia getting a free trade deal with Europe. Jane?
Well, France and Australia have rekindled their romance in the City of Love. French President Emmanuel Macron waving au revoir to the rift that was caused by the cancellation of the submarine contract in a meeting overnight with Prime Minister Anthony Albanese. Let's bring in today's talkers, Liberal Senator Jane Hume and Nine News presenter Tom Wren. Jane, we'll begin with you. It seems that the Prime Minister has sweet-talked us back into the good books.
Yes, I think that Anthony Albanese has unruffled those ruffled feathers in France, which is a good thing. You know, Australia's relationship with France is very deep and goes right back to World War One and World War Two. There's 45,000 Australians that lost their lives on French soil, defending French soil back in that time. And since then, we've had relations that have gone up and down, or you'll call, you know, France dropping nuclear bomb tests in French Polynesia in the 1980s and 1990s. So diplomatic relations have ebbed and flowed, and it's good to see them back on track. The good news is Anthony Albanese did not apologise for that AUKUS agreement. That's a very important strategic agreement for Australia. We should never apologise for making decisions in the national interest, particularly when it comes to national security.
Is this a case of good diplomacy, or is it the extraordinary amount of money we paid them not to build submarines?
Well, it's certainly French were very well compensated for cancelling that contract, but I think that everybody understands that when you make a decision like that, that's in the national security, in the national interest, you know, this is how diplomatic relations ebb and flow over history.
Hey, Tom, does this make it awkward for the former Prime Minister, given that his successor seems to be butting up with Emmanuel Macron?
Look, possibly, but I think Jane makes a really good point in that we didn't want to be seen to be grovelling back to the French. And I think it was a real test for Anthony Albanese and probably the first international test for him in terms of diplomacy. And I think he came through with flying colours. And certainly from an outsider looking in, I mean, Jane's far more schooled to talk about this than I am, but I think it was really important that we didn't appear to be going back hands on, you know, hands and knees type stuff. So I think it was a really good effort by Anthony Albanese, maybe slightly awkward for his predecessor, but I guess we move on now.